Good morning. This is a special service today. Wasn't that great as you came up and saw the flags on Lake Shore? Those who came in this, we thank you for the men and women that put those flags up. They'll do it today and tomorrow, and they'll put it down tonight, and then the team will come back. And so thank you for that. It really helps us as today is a special day. And the church is Pentecost and our country Memorial Day weekend. And we're going to celebrate and remember both of them today in our service. And especially we have a baptism today of two brothers, Andrew and Ethan. And so Andrew is 6 years old and his little brother is, how many months is he? Six. All right. 6 years old and 6 months. And so a great celebration today with the family with Gene and Hal Kisling. And so on that note, let's do our memory verse that's in the front page of your bulletin, Proverbs 6, chapter 22. Together, train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it. And that's been the month of May of graduations of preschool, high school, college. And we thank the Lord for the family. And today is the birthday of the church, Pentecost, and the training that we receive here in all our churches. So on that note, now it's time to begin our worship this morning. Would you please rise? And as we begin our invocation, let us pray. Gracious Father, we thank you today, of all days, of the birthday of our church. And how fitting it was to have a baptism birthday as well with Andrew and Ethan. Lord, guide us in our study this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Have you ever had the power go off at your home? Maybe our monsoon seasons, or many of you, we have a family today from Missouri with the tornadoes. Whatever power struggle or pull goes out, the power goes off, you have no electricity, and what do? You got to wait. And you got to wait until help is on its way. And the disciples had that a couple times in their journey with Jesus. First on Good Friday when he passed away on the cross. Could you imagine that? All that excitement and power for 3 years with Jesus, all of a sudden it's gone. Then 3 days later they see the risen Lord, and what a celebration that was. And then 40 days later, ascension, Jesus goes into heaven. Could you imagine? Hey, wait, Jesus. Where are you going? We just had great, 37 days of seeing your resurrected body, and now he's leaving us again. And they had to wait 10 days to Pentecost, and Pentecost means 50 in the Greek language, 50. And this was another celebration. If you go to Leviticus chapter 23, you'll see the celebrations from the Passover. And then 7 days later, seven Sabbath day later, they celebrate this Feast of Weeks, this Pentecost, this time of maybe two celebrations. One of celebrating receiving the law at Mount Sinai, the Ten Commandments, and then celebrating with food with each other. So it was a great kind of like going down to Prescott Courthouse, enjoying all that good food, walking around all those booths and people from different ethnic groups coming together and celebrating. And so we see this Pentecost for us today is God's plan to advance the kingdom of God. One of my favorite games was Risk growing up. And it was a fun game of Risk because you got to take over the world. And you with the dice and all the moving. And this is exactly what God calls us to do, is to advance his kingdom, to expand God's kingdom, and that is to be a part of God's family. In this congregation, you've done it 5 times this week with 5 baptisms. And we had 2 last weekend, families that connected with God's world years ago, and now, and this past Wednesday, we had a child, a couple years old, a disabled child that won't have a long life, that was baptized in one of our homes. And then today we thank you, Andrew, bringing your family and your brother Ethan to expand God's kingdom of his love and grace and celebration. And that's what we see in Acts. And what a great job with the choir. Let's thank our hands with the choir this morning. Yeah, that was cool. And all the languages, thank you for reading the languages and pronouncing in their particular culture of German and Spanish and Italian and so on. So thank you so much for showing us that God's kingdom is for the world, for all of us, no matter what group we belong, what ethnic group. But here's our challenge today. is that a lot of times with our sins stops us in our tracks. And the Old Testament talks about Ezekiel of the valley of bones, of dry bones. Not only 3,000 years ago when the Israelites were exiled from their home and went to Babylon, the prophet Ezekiel, boy, as the Lord showed him a valley of dry bones, as sin stops us in our tracks. We're dead without God. We're dead without our Savior, Jesus Christ. We're dead without the Holy Spirit moving us forward. And so that's what's cool about the Old Testament, chapter 37, talks about, is that we've lost hope. We had to leave our homes, we're in a different land, and we've lost hope. How many times have we lost hope in our lives? The different challenges that we go through, the loss of life of our loved ones, to jobs and relationships and financial difficulties and just the ugliness of this life from day to day, we can lose hope. That's why as a Christian church, and the early Christian church baptized infants right from the beginning to celebrate, is that without God, we have no hope. With God, we have the world and the great celebration. And that's what's cool about the gospel of the next slide. It's kind of like Halloween. All of a sudden, these bones came together and became an army. All right, an army of skeletons. Can you imagine that? That must have been something for Ezekiel to see, the rattling of the bones coming together. And then from then, flesh coming together and bringing us new life. We might quickly want to move that picture on. For me, I'm a little nervous watching that screen. But he brings us new life. It brings us together. And this is why the Pentecost is so important. That's why we celebrate that. We Christians, we don't have the strength on our own to go through this life with the challenges. We will fall short and we will lose hope. But this is why we celebrate baptism of any age, that God comes to us. And that's what we celebrate. Christ came from heaven to earth through Christmas to celebrate the Messiah's here, all the way through Easter, the empty tomb, the empty cross, to celebrate that we struggle. Yesterday I had breakfast with a man of my age, and he has no strength. But he knew who to call. Trinity. And that I could, through you, I could encourage him today. You don't need the strength. Let me tell you who's got the strength for you today, and that's our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who inspires us through the Holy Spirit to give us the strength we need to go from day to day. And that's what we celebrate, is that now we all have a language that we can share the love of Jesus. Now, of course, we all have the English language, but the language could be something that you enjoy doing, your passion in life, what you like to do. You like to fish? You know, Andrew, you can share Christ through your swimming, and when you learn to fish with your dad or your grandpa, whatever you do, whatever you like to do, that's the joy of your life. You can share Jesus no matter what you do. If you play video games, or you're out kicking the soccer ball, or you love to read. And that's the beauty that we have, the beautiful Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today is also Memorial Day weekend. And remember the men and women that have given their lives for us in this young country of over just a little bit over 200 years. And as we remember the men and women who have given their lives to us, how could they do that? Because of the courageous spirit of our veterans here today as well, is that you see a bigger cause to expand the freedom of this country, physical and spiritual. And we thank you guys for serving. There's a powerful story that the Lutheran Hour, some of you listen to Lutheran Hour 7 o'clock on the radio. It's a Lutheran message that goes around the world. And they ended with this message this morning. In World War II, at one of the prisoner camps of the American and British, they made a homemade radio that the Nazis did not find. And they heard in that radio program is that the Germans were going to surrender. It'd be three more days before the Allies got to this camp. But you imagine, they said in this article, for those next 3 days, the soldiers had a little more hope, a little more strength. They start waving to the Nazi guards. They start singing a little bit in their weakness because they knew hope was on its way. And that's what we celebrate today. And we thank our Lord who gave his life for us for the incredible eternal freedom. And we thank our men and women who have given their lives in our service. Those who are veterans today, like Mark Getzmeyer, 20 years in the Navy, in the submarines, underneath water most of his lifetime to make sure that we're protected. And many of you from wartime and peacetime, we thank you. We're going to end with this video of an 11-year-old boy. 11-year-old boy who went to that beach on June 6th, 70 years anniversary of when we stormed Normandy. Listen to this narration.
In June 2014, my 11-year-old son and I went to Normandy, France for the 70th anniversary of D-Day. As part of his personal remembrance project called Project Vigil, he spent 4 days in the American cemetery teaching visitors about 3 paratroopers buried there. On D-Day, June 6th, the local police wouldn't let him enter the cemetery, so he took his 48-star World War II-era American flag down to Omaha Beach and planted his homemade flagpole firmly in the sand. All he wanted to do was say thank you to the young Americans who fought and died on that beach exactly 70 years earlier. Together, we unfurled the flag into the wind, where it whipped and snapped with such force that he strained to hold it steady. When he turned his gaze to the English Channel, he saw a vision of the spirits of our infantry soldiers heading for the shore on D-Day morning. He was so moved by this vision, he raised his hand to salute them. And for a moment, he was just a little boy with a flag, standing alone on a beach in Normandy. He held the flag and his salute for an hour and a half.
As he stood there saluting, he quietly hummed the old songs his heroes would have loved. While he hummed Glenn Miller's American Patrol, he thought of the young infantrymen who held that cheerful song so dearly in their hearts as they lived the final moments of their lives. And as he imagined their lives ending in violent, horrible deaths upon the same sand of the bloody Omaha, as he stood, he began to cry. He briefly broke his salute to wipe away those tears. After a while, people began to come down to the water to see the saluting boy. Children approached to see if he was real. Some teased him to try to break his concentration. Others wanted to have their picture taken with him. Then came the TV news. But he didn't smile. His eyes remained fixed on the image of the spirits of our soldiers coming ashore. When the tide crept in, he refused to retreat a single step. Members of our armed forces encouraged him. our veterans saluted him. And then a lone trumpeter joined him in his vigil.
After an hour had passed, his knees began to weaken, and the muscles in his arms and hands began to cramp. But he didn't want to leave the beach. He stayed strong, for them and for their memory. Then came the moment when he raised his right hand, a signal that he was ready to say goodbye. I took the flag, and he collapsed in my arms. As I held him, I was struck by a deep sadness for all the mothers and fathers who never had a chance to comfort their sons in June 1944.
That was very nice. Thank you. And through baptism and through the whole Pentecost, what a great hope that our sons and daughters and our in a variety of different wars that they have protected us in this world, that through baptism they are adopted in God's family and their home safe. And so we thank the men and women at this time. And now.